Alright, so here we are again. Going to play another quest in the world of theme creation. But we're actually going to play something special today. We're going to be playing a quest I made quite recently. I finished this quest February of this year, 15 February 2020. So this is actually going to be the first time I'll be playing a quest I recently released. It's called Evil Quest, and I'm actually quite happy with it. I've actually been looking forward to getting to this one. I think it's going to be quite amusing. Evil Quest. So we'll be playing as Wile Evil. We're going to be holding a daily meeting, and nothing of value will be accomplished. We'll see about that, actually. Right, so we're going to do a biannual inspection of our evil castle. So something to note about this quest. This scene right now, I made this scene in like 2013. This is a quest I've actually worked on in the years like 2013, then 14, then 17, and then like 2020. It's actually kind of interesting. This is a quest I've made over the course of 7 years. Not 7 years of consecutive work, but just like 7 years of sometimes coming back to this quest and working on it for a bit, until then finally finishing it in 2020. So this all happens, this was all made like 2013, this first scene. And it is very 2013 in writing also. Like it's very much vintage Mania writing here. Right, so our throne doesn't even have a nice cushion. Horrible. Your excellence. Right, so yeah, very Mania this. Very Mania. We're not missing any teeth, luckily. Though it is hard to tell because our mouth is always closed in this portrait. So here we go. There's that very important innuendo. Lovely. Titillating, it's a good word. Oh ho! Oh my. This not but the patchy ramblings of a deluded old god. So here's the best character with the best accent. So loved. I loved writing this character. She's just so grim, dark, and edgy. L. Lovely place, lovely.
Naughty? It is I, Lord Naughtiness, the naughtiest, nastiest lord of them all. And I did in fact come here to peek at you while you were sleeping. That's just how naughty I am.
Voice acting, oh my. Oh dear, Buns. Oh gods.
What a delightfully naughty joke!
Very naughty.
I'm going to stand right here, no matter what any of you might think, because I'm just that naughty!
Very inconsiderate, and he also is wearing a very pretty dress.
What? This is no dress! This is a rope! A naughty rope! You rope!
Spiked bells, very cool. I like the way the matriarch thinks. Let's just all be naked. Yes.
Bleed in black tight cat suits. Oi.
Gibberish! Nonsense! What we need are robes! Naughty robes!
I'm so glad that nobody's home to hear me say that. Very unexpected replies. Hi. It's Sally. Everybody loves Sally. Lovely, lovely Sally. Young man. I'm Sally, and I'm a girl. Yes, quaint. Scandalous. No. Nay.
Ooh, how naughty it'd be! But I'm very self-conscious!
Sort of. Bleeding Scally!
How dare you insult the Lord of Naughtiness, you filthy biomass! Ugh, disgusting!
Disgusting, disgusting biomass. Blatant discrimination. Oh, oh dear. Yeehaw! Oh, the writing. It's so 2013. Amazing. Report. Internship in the industry of evil. I mean, that is actually what I do, kind of. Maybe? Medicine manufacturing. That is very evil.
Import-export business.
Yes, let's go with that. Oh, more innuendo from the matriarch. I love that facial expressions he's making. Like, the facial expressions of the meek women are actually really good, because they have like this very DreamWorks face, like eyebrow set, which is just amazing. You can make a lot of funny facial expressions with the bold and the meek characters. I actually really wish you could do the same with the goblins. That would be amazing. Yes, of course. yes. Relatable. This was before I got a job, and my god, it wasn't very far from what was actually going to happen. Finding a job is just horrible. Yes, why are we here? That's a good question.
We came here for an evil meeting! Evilly naughty, that is!
But its voice is horrible. Yes, the tests of volunteers, yes.
Positive thinking is a typo!
Horrible. Oh dear. Oh dear. Awkward pauses. Ah yes, the Paladins Guild. We'll be seeing some paladins. Some familiar faces maybe? Or maybe not so familiar faces. Oh my. Yes, very tiring. It's been 8 minutes and we're still in the opening cutscene. This opening cutscene goes on very long. Finally.
Inspection.
Yeah, the inspection. It's when you inspect stuff. Wow, really?
Yes, inspect all the furniture.
Actually, no. Horrible. But we will be examining some furniture, maybe. Actually, we can control the character now. So we are playing as Wile E. Vile, which is a great name. I really love that name, Wile E. Vile. So we do have custom equipment. We have an evil sword, which is just so evil that even among evil swords it stands out to being just so darn evil. We have our evil robes, very gothic, very dank, very stylish. We have our greaves. Freaking laser beams. I do love the descriptions of the items here, they're great. Pure concentrated evil. Yes, good is very dense. If you're wondering, why does it add that specific amount of HP, so that I get this amount of HP? Maybe I should have gone for like 666 HP, but that would be very, how do you put it, cliché. Wily Vile is very obviously not cliché. Plagiarism. Right, and then we do have some spells. I believe Utter Despair is a debuffing spell. I believe Sheer Terror is also a debuffing spell, and I believe Pure Contempt is just a basic damaging spell. We don't have anything else. So we can't examine any furniture. Lies, we can examine this throne chair. Oh dear, Einam Gif is surprised, and we get this secret dialogue. Who could this Einam Gif be? No clue, very mysterious character. Indeed. Yes, so this is also just referencing the fact that in the end of the quest, we will be coming back here and examining this chair.
Go on, brave warrior!
Music to my ears. That was a very, Yeah. Is his face frozen? Well, I'll be in my room. I hope you'll join me later, my most loved lord. I don't.
Oh my wonder! What is that?
What? Aw, oh, we've been had. Rude? So rude. Horrible.
No.
Oh dear. Oh Sally. Trying to prove herself. Bye. Well, that was fun. In case you're wondering, why did the screen just flash black? If you try to leave without talking to all the NPCs, I make the NPCs despawn. I had to do that in order to prevent the play from sequence breaking. Well, we still haven't advanced the plot stage yet. Also, I hope my neighbors aren't hearing that. That would be very awkward.
Yes! The goblins! We've reached the goblins! Yeah! The goblins! Finally!
Salutations, a weird small green man! Yes. The personal guard of goblins! I wish I had one of those. Just a whole gaggle of goblins guarding me and standing around me and being cute. Aww. I would like that. Hideously mutated human children. They do look a bit like hideously mutated children, but in a cute way. An adorable way. Oh my. Punish me, guard chief senpai. No. I really need the money. Well, if you go talk to the chair again. Oh my, new dialogue. So we have advanced to the next plot state. So our quest, our goal, we need to find a cushion. Well, that's a grand quest, isn't it? So we will be finding a cushion and also some other items which we will need to pimp out our throne room and ourselves. Sir. Carry on. How do you wink with only one eyeball? That's a good question. Very cute. Oh, Wilevi is very cute. Look at that cute face. and here we come to the best part of the quest. The fact that this quest has like dozens and dozens of goblins to talk with. All with unique dialogue. Literally dozens. I think there's more than 80. And they're all great. Oh, you are sexy. You are sexy. Well, that's very sad, but you are also very sexy. And cute. Cute goblins. Cute and sexy. So the dialogue is very... I just adore the dialogue of the goblins in this quest. It's amazing. Oh, I love it. I love the dialogue of the goblins. It's so good. You would look great in it. Darling, you would look amazing. Goblins with suits of armor. Very scintillating. No intruders. No intruders.
No!
I love the dialogue. Lots of like gags with like the rule of three thing. Well, like the first one is always just a silly gag, building on the other two. Aww. Aww.
Aww.
So if you're wondering, I did actually label all the guard dialogues internally with numbers. So they do actually all have assigned numbers, even though most of them don't really reference their numbers. Might makes white. The mighty have whites. Might is a white. Very laser lords. Very, very laser lords. Where am I? Oh dear, it's a goblin gardener. Why is he here? Very mysterious. What does the goblin say? What? Ah, the goblins are great. When? Who? Why? Important questions. Very important questions. Where? Whence? Oh, thank you. Your face also looks very delicious. Look at it. Love that. Oh, the goblins are so cute. I'm going to say that a lot in this quest, that goblins are cute, but well, the thing is, they are cute. Teehee! Hee hee!
Ugh!
Love it. Oh, the goblins are so cute. Look at them, their noses are touching! Oh, so cute! Oh, tingly. Yuffie love. So this is a side quest. We will be coming back to this goblin and giving him a suit of armor to wear. 2 plus 2 equals 4. 2 times 2 equals 4. And 2 to the power of 2 equals 4. Interesting math fact. Oh, we come to the main hall. So it's not only goblins, there's also more people to talk with. Including ogres, who are not as cute as goblins, but still very cute. Ogre butler maid. It is a bit much. My skirt itches. Aw, great.
Everybody who enters this castle is greeted with my butt.
I mean, if I entered a castle and the first thing I saw was a goblin's butt, I would be very impressed. I would be very impressed. Hi, I'm Mai. Bye. Oh, the dialogue is amazing. This is also, like, I believe, all written in, like, 2013. Although the goblins were actually added in 2020. One of the last things I added in the quest was, like, making sure that basically every room has at least one goblin. Which is, like, a very important thing to put in your quest, right? If not all your rooms have a goblin, just in general, in life, but also in fiction, you're doing something wrong. You need more goblins. I am Marie. Not Maria, and certainly not Mania. You wouldn't want to be Mania. That would be horrible. Dude, man, this bot, man. Dude, it's like wicked awesome, Broseph. What? Whoa, bro. The great goblin in the sky, man. Goblin? No. So let's see, where should we go first? I think I'm going to do the outside area first. Man, this port is foul. Serious whack, man. Oh dear. Oh my, now we have another goblin.
So exposed. I like it.
My most prized possession. The ultimate plan. With my back to the wall, how do you protect your back from your own back? That's a good question. There's no way I can shank myself. It would be very dumb, yes? It would be very stupid if in the events of this quest a character wound up attacking himself. Luckily, that is not going to happen, so do not worry about it. I was thinking of dubbing myself the Woke Rouge. Oh, sorry, I meant the Rouge Woke. I fucked it up. It is too confusing. Way too confusing.
Welcome, I am Vat the Vampire. Will you let me bite you?
No. Okay then, I shall make sure not to bite you then, my good friend. So I did try to have a variety of NPCs in this quest, you know, not only humans and goblins and ogres, but like, creatures of all kinds are welcome in this quest. Firm! Thick! Hee hee! My garden's doing excellent!
Excellent! Much more than that stupid other garden. Ha! What a whoop! You can't even call this a competition!
Then I guess I shan't.
Oh! I am a spooky ghost! I'm so scared of myself!
I can't! I'm made up of ectoplasm!
Well, that does suck.
What greater fear is there than fear itself?
No, actually.
What greater fear is there than yourself? Our ends will come by our very own hands!
Ominous foreshadowing? Probably not. I'm doing a lot of silly voices. Oh flowers, I pray to you, grow. In the name of the Lord, oh hallelujah, plant a seed of faith for just $5.99. Plant a seed of faith into this fertile soil, dear Lord Almighty. Oh god. Blorble. Blorb.
My pixie magic will make you grow.
Chomp, 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 chomp. I sure love eating grass. Oh dear. I do love this NPC a lot. I am a lazy twig joke. Very lazy. Yeah, I admit it. I'm a talking fish. Impressed? Sounds a bit fishy. Get lost, mate.
You shall take no liberties with me. I am a woman decora with standards. Did you not see my name? It was a woman with dinners, right? Sigh.
Oh dear, well, I will have to take a little bit of a break before I talk with this NPC. So, I walk the malls. I start how I park my car. I get out of the car and I close the door and I do some warm-ups. You know, this may seem very silly to you, but I warm up one foo! One foo! One foo! And I get my heart pumping so that I have enough oxygen that blows up into the brain. Some people think that this is silly, but I really don't. I want to tell you that this really helps me keep me in shape. Why, I used to walk with the Blissfield Club, and the Blissfield Club walked in all of the parks, but they walked in the rain. And then I read an article in a magazine. I don't remember which magazine, but I read an article about the people who are allowed in the pool at 7 o'clock in the morning. And they get in and they walked and walked and walked and walked and walked. So I joined that. So I became a happy walker girl. And I even made up a song. And if you don't think it's silly, yes. I am a happy walker girl. I love to hike the pool. And as I love to swim and swim and swim and swim. You know, it goes like Balvery, Balvera. I have lifelong power. Balvery, Balvera. Balvery, Balvera. I love to swim and swim. And the combination of both makes me feel better, makes me feel wonderful. And I would like to show you what I bought myself. Something I bought just for myself. Something to equip to myself with. It's a Piff helmet! It'll be the symbol of the happy hiking girl. And when I get more people interested, I'm going to have my own newsletter. The Piff helmet will be the symbol of the happy hiking girls. Walking through the pools, swimming through the pools. You may think it's not silly, it's wonderful. It's something you can do for yourself. If you're a modern woman, this is what you want to do for yourself. You can get out there on your own and make your own money and that you earn every day and go out and swim and get healthy while you're doing it. Wow. Oh god. So, if you've ever seen the video of the, crazy mall walking lady, this is just like basically verbatim copy pasted that whole video. I love the energy of that lady. I think she's great. I think she's amazing. I'm genuinely curious, you know, did that thing of hers work out? Like the mall walking thing? I hope for her that it did work out. Also, yeah, no, I'm not going to talk to her again. God, that certainly took a lot of energy. I'm not going to do another voice for a moment. I need to recover. vexing. Very vexing indeed.
Mr. Fancy Pants got banks of cash.
Who's the man? I'm the man. You are cool to me. Who's the woman? I'm the woman. City dialogue.
I almost drowned.
Yeah. Good. But we can enter the castle and encounter my favorite NPC. Step closer, brave wanderer. Speak with me. So, you have found... It is I, the knight. No, that is not my full name. You may address me as...
The Goblin Knight!
An NPC so good and so pure that it doesn't even exist in the engine. Beautiful. I love the Goblin Knight. I love suits of armor and I love knights. I love you, Goblin Knight. You're amazing. Yes, all day loving himself in his inflatable castle of suits of armor. That's the life, isn't it? That is way cooler than whatever the hell Whiny Vile does. Goblin Knight, you're so awesome, you're so cool. You get the knight's armor and greaves. Hold it right there, bucko. I mean, this is like obvious, but a knight is already a knight after having a cool helmet. Like, the helmet is like 100% of what makes a knight a knight. If you just take a swole dude with a helmet, that's a knight. If you remove the knight, then it's just a swole dude. But the knight needs a helmet. Yes, it's the best kind of helmet. That's the best kind of helmet. An absolute best. Foolish. Lovely. Totally sick. So if you're wondering why a cool skull helmet, it's the only helmet I could think of. There aren't any other helmets like items, so I just use the skull prop. It is too powerful. Oh dear, yeah. Me player characters can't wear helmets. That is quite horrible. But the Goblin Knight believes in us. Standing motionlessly, that's the real life. I love the Goblin Knight, what a great NPC. Yeah, this is far too cool for us, and oh dear, my little pony reference. Bling! Handsome reflection, comically oversized codpiece. Well, the Goblin Knight. Very well endowed, especially considering he's a goblin. I mean, we know a lot of things about goblins if we watch the Dutch Quest video, in which I detail certain elements of biology regarding goblins and other species. Don't watch it. Oh my! Impressive! It's true, I do have to pee all the time. I admit it. Toilets! Oh my god! A toilet!
Heeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee
Yeah, wow.
I hate this toilet. The music here is terribly unfitting. This tree makes no sense for a toilet. Why does this place look like a temple? Why do we need to be your Boo urns? Why are the lanterns blue? Blech! I don't like these dancing flowers. Flowers don't dance. Makes me so angry.
I'm so angry. I love that name. This is also like one of my favorite NPCs. He's just great. I'm a toilet! I wanna be a toilet when I grow up! Well, don't let me get in the way of your weird fetishes. Nay, I do say I need to pee a lot. So, best room in the quest. I'm pooping right now. Poop! I'm getting way too into all this. Oh my god, evil quest. Oh my god, there are more toilets!
I dare to declare there are no toilets at all. This shall not do for a princess such as I. Princess Cornia, no, say it's not so. It is indeed most verily a truly so, yes, or so and so even. By the 17¼ gods, there can be only one solution to this. Oh, my lordly lord, green lord, what shall the solvent solution be? I promote you to Queen of Spleen, queens to eat toilets. I doubly do double declare I want a gorgeous spleen on my horn. What a curious tale. Also, I think my face is stuck. It hurts so much.
Voice acting. Oh my, look at this beautiful room. Look at this beautiful goblin! Handsome Blin, the most goblin, handsome goblin ever. So handsome. So handsome!
I'm the closest to a goblin on this mortal coil. I have the tightest tights, I have the curliest feet, I have the largest fangs, I have the squintiest eyes, I have the waxiest ears, I have the bumpiest horns, I have the largest bulge, I have the longest transfer. Oh my, oh my, yes!
My god, I'm doing so much voice acting.
Greetings, my lord.
The matriarch?
No, my lord, you may name me. Name me.
In case you're wondering, name me is the default name of NPCs.
I shall name you Dorikins the Fifth. No, I mean my name is Name Me. In that case, I shall name you Lady Thunderkill the Eighth. That's not what I meant. I'm called Name Me. Henceforth, you shall be called the Extreminator. But that's it. I'll call you B-Butt. I could work with that.
I should have actually had the NPC transform into an NPC called B-Butt, but I didn't.
Why in the bleeding black pitches of hell am I in here?
Maybe these are the bleeding black pitches of hell. I mean, if I went to the bleeding black pitches of hell, I think it would look a lot like this quest.
Yeah, it is. Might be the bleeding black pitches of hell, but for me it was the Tuesday.
It's not Tuesday.
Gosh, not your blight-hearted, belt-spoying maggot of crap! There's no simple Tuesday, nay, it's Tuesday!
What?
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 That's right.
Ah, crap, I've gotta give you some of that.
Beautiful. Gesundheit.
Oh, see what is. Definitely a warrior only when you're done, Yavin.
We got an eyeball! Lovely! And we will be sticking this up and down our ass wormhole.
Yes!
Oh, amazing. So if you're wondering, the goal of this quest is to find 6 of these items given to us by our understudies, let's say. So that's the first of 6, I mean 5, first of 5. And here we have Pop. There appears to be nobody here but me, Pop.
I'm not here. There's nothing here but Pop.
I love it. It's great. Here I come to the irrelevant maze. I love this room. It's great. This room is amazing. I love this room. I had a lot of fun making it.
Inconceivable! Bingo from Dutch Quest, why are you here? Why are you here? You'll find the real Pinko.
Essence of Pinkness must have drawn you here. Say no more, fair friend. Just take it from a special friend deep in the forest. Pinkness.
Yeah, I mean, you would think that someone like Pinko would need Pinkness.
Pish posh, my good sir. Where I am going, my Pinkness is sufficient. Wowzers, of course. Come, let's head to the Netherlands together.
Oh, let's not. Let's absolutely not go to Dutch Quest, please.
Okay then. Very well. Pinko power!
Okay, but seriously, what?
I'm doing so many silly voices. This is truly the laser lords of my quests.
Lost? Frightened? Confused? Good!
That was my I am mean impression. My horrible, very bad, no good I am mean impression. Oh dear, I have to do more voice acting. Welcome, my lord. Welcome to my room. Why, yes. Do you feel like playing in the sand? Ugh, gross. Shall we go play in the water, then? What if there are sharks? What? Sharks? There are no sharks. Is that what the sharks told you? There are no sharks.
They did tell you!
No!
So, they didn't even tell you they were in the water. Crafty.
Crafty indeed. Go fetch me some sharks, my dear matriarch. Oh, my lord, my dearest. Anything for you. And then when I collect the sharks, we can...
Yes. We can ride them into the sunset, and mount them with laser beams, and have a giant laser disco show! Good enough. Well then, I shall go fetch your sharks. In the meantime, take this, and think of me. Farewell. Oh my. What an old woman. Oh right, so yeah, while Evile's mother is also called the Matriarch, they are two distinct NPCs, but they have the same names. It's almost like when I made this quest, I took a 6-year break in the middle of it. Almost. Whoa! Limited edition! I love that line from that one game. If you've played that game, you know what I'm talking about. Well, the name is AI The Somnium Files, and it's a wonderful game. Pinkness flows through this flower.
You are positively pink!
Lovely.
Check out these coconuts!
I would like to do that. Look at all these goblins.
I got sand in my tights!
Again. Very much hoping that nobody is hearing me yell all this stuff. That will be very cringeworthy. I am very much aware that this whole video will be very cringeworthy, but I don't care, I'm too excited.
Be careful, sir, there's sand back there.
I think there might be a giant boat behind me. Boats turn me on. Sometimes I like to bury my feet in the sand, it tickles. Aw, that's cute. I'm on a special sand diet. I only eat sand cookies.
I hate beaches so much!
I love the goblin dialogue. God, I'm enjoying this quest so much. I'm having so much fun. I'm really glad I got to this quest. Yes, I am the decorator of this room. This is what true art is all about. Don't like it? Well, you can take one of these fences and stick it up your rectum.
I might just do that.
Yeah, true art.
The decorator told me to put a pole in my butt, so I did!
Well, if the goblin enjoys it, then that's good for him. I'm glad he enjoys having a pole up his butt. I know I would. Oh man. This is going to be quite a video once I release it. I'm looking forward to rewatching it.
Oh my god, there's so many fences here! Shut up, you non-believer! These fences are simply divine!
How did he get here?
This is my dream home!
I would like to live here, because there are a lot of goblins. Ooh, look at this handsome ogre. Oh, hello. You have found your way to my shed. Excellent. Please, won't you come in? My dear mother matriarch Evile always told me not to enter a stranger's shed. My name is Mr. Shed. I am pleased to make your acquaintance. Now please, I ask of you. I implore you. Enter my shed. Well, alright, you seem like a very trustworthy fellow.
Well, so much, so many. Yes, I have all the soul of that merchandise. It is all mine. May I see it again? No, never again.
Pretty please?
No, never again. So if you talk with this NPC here, a hidden secret goblin, the best kind of goblin.
Mr. Shed, he's so dreamy.
Yes, very dreamy.
Secret area of goblins. Yay, yay, yay. Here lie Goblin Guard 76's hopes and dreams. Wait, I'm Goblin Guard 76. This ball tastes funny. Interspecies romance!
Swoosh, swoosh. Aww, cute. Cute, cute, cute.
Houses with goblins! Yeah! Welcome to my shop! Now get out!
Oh my. We are back in the castle! How can this be? Oh, hello there! Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Not one of my minions. Who are you?
Oh, I'm just a lost fae, really. Used to live in this quaint village, deep in an enchanted forest with the other fae. Then a bunch of bliss bozos kicked us all out. Horrible. So we cursed a whole lot. Whole place is abandoned now. Hilarious! We even set up a bit of a portal system using some enchanted ladders. How swell. I shall be making much use out of your enchanted ladders, then. Not so hasty. You gotta pay toll first. Toll. In my own castle. What a silly idea. Imp's gotta make a living. Touch of mercantilism! I have a special interest in goblins. And no, not your limited edition magazines. I want the good stuff. I do want the good stuff also. Talk to me again when you have some. Well then, did you get the good goblin stuff? No, we didn't. Not yet. We will be getting it soon. Eventually. Maybe. Meh. I tire of the humble totem of everyday life. When will a destruction sentiment bad boy come sweep me away? Ah, right. So this is a bit of a cheeky reference to one of the pre-packaged quests in this engine, which featured a shy, meek creation girl who got swept away by a destruction boy who was very bad. But it was a lot less wholesome than that cute little goblin. It was not very to my taste, so I made a little bit of a joke about it here. I'm married! I'm divorced! Oh, I love the jokes.
Nani!
So this castle, this ladder connects back to the goblin night room. So just a bit of a handy shortcut. Also, yeah, this is just also like one of those like secret things. It is fun that you these trees are so huge that you can actually like hide stuff beneath them. It's what makes me like the forest style set so much, being able to hide stuff. Oh man. Oh. This is a song about a bush most foul. Mean as a snake and wise as an owl, feeding on a lucre's most naive, gobbling it up until late in the eve. Yet return to this bush we shall, finally consume us it will all. That was horrible. I'm not good at singing. I'm very bad at singing, I admit it.
Did that bush just wiggle? Eek! Hold me, I'm scared!
I wish a goblin would jump up in my arms and eek. That'd be very cute. So before we advance, there is something we have to do. We have a little bit of a side quest. Do you have any suits that I could try on? I need one for reasons. Aww. Wow, sir, you're the best. Damn right I am. Oh my gob! You actually got me a suit of armor! And a skull helmet! These will look great on me! Wow, sir, you truly are the best! Really, truly damn white I am! Heen, I'm so giddy!
Oh.
Oh. Oh. It hurts. It hurts. When would that be? Any minute now! It hurts so much.
It hurts. Yes. I secreted it with love.
Goblin earwax!
No, it's not earwax, my dear. Lovely. Did I mention yet that this quest is not PG-13? It's not. Oh, I do like to think about that. I'm imagining it right now. Lovely. Sticky, tangy, chalky, and goblin yellow. Delicious! Lovely. Well, now you know. Where shall we go next? I think we shall go here next. Yes. Ugh, the boring library, how boring.
Oh my Oma! I am literally a flying eyeball! My whole existence is hell on earth! If I do not flap for a second, I fall to the ground in writhing agony! The slightest nudge into something pierces my eyeball into a bloody mess! My tears only burn my eyes even more, rendering me blind! My whole life has been nothing but misery and pain! Omna, why? Why?
Such a nice poem.
My pain is not a poem! So grim dark. Oh. Give me a hug.
Why me?
Please just end my misery, I cannot even do it myself. I tried to fling myself into a bookshelf, but it just horribly burned my retinas. I would never harm a fly.
Never. Why leave Ryle may be evil, but he would never harm a fly.
The paladin took off his greaves and firmly grabbed the shaman's comically oversized sausage.
Let's boogie, ejaculated the shiny domed champion confidently. Love it.
Why are there no emoticons with just a single eye? This is speciesist.
How do you have a tongue?
That's not a tongue.
I now know.
We live in an unjust world, unkind to us one-eyed beings. Not that you would understand.
You think? Yeah, I mean, I think he would understand. Oh, right. Let's see, we can talk to this guy. I swear, if I have to read one more book, I am burning this whole place down. I also sometimes feel the urge to do that. Burn it.
Burn it.
I like books.
I really like books.
I'm researching myself. I wish it weren't going very well. I'm researching why my research isn't going very well. It's not going very well. I'm researching ways to research. It's not going very well. Researcher? I hardly know her! I'm developing new ways of doing research. Someone's going to put the D in R&DZ. Yeah, walked right into that one. I'm researching ways to improve my research. It's not going very well.
I'm researching ways to be an R&DZ when I grow up. It's not going very well.
It's going very well. I'm researching ways to reverse my dialogue order. I'm researching. It's not going very well. I'm researching ways to differentiate myself from my fellow R&DZ.
It's going very well.
I'm researching an innovative joke to put in my next dialogue box. It's not going very well. I'm not even doing any research. Somehow it's not going very well. I see you have finally arrived. I've been waiting for you. While, look at this egg. In a few moments, I will drop this egg. I want you to consider whether this egg is boiled. The truth is, I myself do not know. Until this egg falls onto the ground, we cannot know whether the egg is boiled or not. Once this egg does reach the floor, wonderful things can happen. Either the egg splatters, spreading eggshell, yolk and egg white all over the floor, or the egg cracks, but otherwise does not splatter. Is the egg boiled or not boiled? The only way to know would be to drop it. So until we drop it, the egg can be of either state, it is unknowable. This means that at this very moment, the status of this egg is in flux. Indeed, we could refer to this egg as Schrödinger's egg. Now, I will drop the egg. As you can see, the egg has splattered. But what if it had not? What if, in another world, I dropped the egg and it merely cracked? I want you to think about that world. I want you to consider the choices that could lead you to that world. Why were we brought here, to this world where the egg splattered? The truth is, while this is no mere egg that I just dropped. Imagine yourself as this egg. Your body, the skeleton and skin, would be the eggshell. Your mind, comprised of memories, would be the egg white. And finally, your sense of self, your personality, would be the yolk. In this universe, the egg has splattered, meaning your body and self would be destroyed. But in another world, a parallel dimension, your egg was boiled. Your body would be battered and bruised, but you would survive. I believe you have a gift. The power to catapult yourself, your egg, to other worlds. You yourself were such an egg, an unboiled egg. But you transferred yourself, your yolk, to another world. A world in which your egg white was boiled. This is how you survived. How you became a half-boiled egg. Your body was damaged, you lost one of your eyes, but your mind, your self, has carried on. So how was it that you catapulted yourself? This is the topic of my research. But not just my research. It has been the research of many Nakane Kurashikos across many different worlds. In a fashion not dissimilar to yours, I have tapped into these other worlds. I have studied my other eggs, my other selves. And they have studied my egg, myself. But your gift is different than mine. While I can temporarily transpose my yolk into another, your yolk has shifted with another, permanently. At any moment you could switch to another world, meaning you might not be the very same while I was talking to when I began our talk. While, I want you to once again look at the floor, look at the egg. Do you notice it? The egg, it's not splattered anymore. That is correct. The truth is, this is not the egg you witnessed me dropping. This is a different egg entirely. An egg from a wholly different world. So now, you finally know the truth. Now, let us begin our final decision game. You can choose one of two options. You can either stay here, in the world of the boiled egg, or you can return to your original world, the world of the splattered egg. Time to decide! I shall return to my original world. So that is your final decision. Very well. Farewell, Mr. Weil. So, you have chosen to return to this world. I have only one final question. Why? I didn't say anything. No, that wasn't it. There was simply nothing to say. Life is simply unfair. I had so much fun writing that conversation. I had way too much fun writing that conversation. Ah, my love letter to visual novels of the Zero Escape variety. That was a lot of fun. Oh god. Yes! Wait, what is an anomna? That's actually a good question, because the people who are watching this video might not know. Do you not even know what we are researching here?
Are we attempting to breach into other timelines? Breaching into people's dreams? That's ridiculous. Unboiling boiled eggs? Well, that is clever. We already do all those things. Then why don't you ever unboil my boiled eggs? You just asked me to boil them again for you. Then why don't you ever boil my unboiled eggs? But you just asked me to unboil them again for you. You can do that? Yes! Excellent. Yes, our research onto the Olma is going along fine. The test subjects report unusual spiritual phenomena and experience a strong sense of bliss. I'm quite confident we might soon breach a path to the realm, and then... Of course! We can ask them to unboil our boiled eggs! Yes, we shall do that. Well then, my most trusted researcher, do carry on. Soon the world shall kneel before us, and then... We have the power to unboil their eggs! And we will charge a margin of up to 10%! Yes. Oh my. Do feel free to eat them, or burn them, or feed them to the dogs. Again! I wouldn't have to if you would feed them boiled eggs, but someone refuses to boil our unboiled eggs. Seriously need to punish that Lord Naughtiness for that. Ugh, naughty, naughty, naughty. Oh, Wael, don't worry. I'm sure he loves you. A data diamond? Interesting. I actually did use the concept of a data crystal in another quest. Maybe I should have actually made it a data diamond. Yeah. I don't think I want to know that much about the dork digestive systems. Let's see, where do we go next? Well, we can talk to more NPCs. Wiggle wiggle, it's the slime of doom! All random! Shake it, baby! Wiggle wiggle! Scandalous! No. I refuse to shake. This jelly is only for eating. It's four, then. Oh yes, that's more like it. Digest me good. I'm dead now. Well, there goes my diet. Ah, four jokes. Wow, this dragon next to me is seriously uncomfortable. Seriously, wow. Also, there's a dungeon here, it's really uncomfortable. Wow, seriously, wow. He's not joking. It is very uncomfortable, we will be going there. There is a dungeon here, filled with cells. All these people, never locked up, to do it as you please. The inhumanity of it all, the cruelty. Why? Why? Why won't you put me in a prison, Daddy? Well, I could be your warden any day. I will swallow your key.
Really?
No, enjoy your freedom, my loyal servant. I would never be so horrid to so stalwart a guardian.
Check gonads! Check gonads!
Is there something wrong with them?
God, I wish!
Uncomfortable. Time for your flu shot! Are you sure? Looks more like a sword than a needle.
Fine then, go die of the flu!
I shall mourn your passing.
Hi there, what do you think of my defender?
It's what I call the shield attached to my abdomen. It looks more like a sword.
Mama never told me I was that kind of bee!
Ha! Pathetic old fool! Prepare to eat steel! Could this be? Yeah! That's right! Feel the power of my standing here while this phantom silverfish appears. Seriously, where did it come from? I'm just looking for the bathroom. Shall we engage in the timeless male ritual of bonding and take a piss together? Yes, please. Good grief, what a bizarre adventure. Good grief, what a transparent reference to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Could this be? Yes.
I stole these tools! My butt likes variety.
We can examine the chair, but there's nothing we can do with the chair.
Too bad.
Logic doesn't work. What? I am the messenger of darkness. I eliminate those who get too close to the truth. My name is Truman. I only speak the truth. You may call me Mr. T.
May I call you Mr. T?
Yes. Logic doesn't work. My name is Lyman. I only tell lies. You may call me Mr. L.
Who are you and what did you do to my good friend Truman?
I am him.
Was that a lie or the truth?
Logic doesn't work. Logic doesn't work. Names can be deceiving. Be careful of who might be deceiving who. Lyman Truman. In case you're wondering, that character is a reference to a character from Yu-Gi-Oh! GX. Truman from Season 4 of GX. The season that was never dubbed, sadly. And we do have the good goblin stuff, the goblin secretion.
Yes!
Yes! This is going straight to my nose. So it was goblin slot. Sure, let's say it was.
You are surprisingly not evil for an imp.
You are surprisingly not evil for an evil overlord.
Nani?
You just did?
You're kind of an old one.
Oh, everything's Gucci.
Gucci, Gucci, Gucci!
Can't an imp just be salty and obsessed with goblins? I believe imps can be fat, you know? They might look a bit evil, but when you actually look at them a bit more closely, imps are actually really cute.
Oh, so cute!
Cute imps. If only there was a tier list for cuteness. The existence of the Olma proves the existence of the Olma. Welcome to our chapel. My name is Dave Chappelle.
Oh, that joke is so stupid.
That imp told me I'm S tier.
What's an S tier?
I don't actually have any eyeballs. The one-eyed man is king in the land of the blind.
Hail to the king, baby.
Okay. I have to take a sip of water before I talk with this NPC.
Hey, ga je mee als je dat wil? Hoor je bij ons, Vinks? Pak een kamer bij de hand. Probeer de kracht te voelen. Hoor de stem van de natuur. Oh, Vinks Club, Vinks. Zie het magische verband. Kom maar laat je overspoelen. Toch weer een avontuur. Oh, Vinks Club. Hey, ga je mee als je dat wil? Hoor je bij ons. Deze wereld zit vol met gevaren. Soms dan hangt er een groot avontuur in de lucht. Dat is voor ons dan een klus om te klaren. Kom elkaar te leren, we kunnen het je leren. Hey, hey, ga met ons mee, Vinks. Pak een kamer bij de hand. Probeer de kracht te voelen, hoor de stem van de natuur. Oh, Vinks Club, Jinx, zie je magische verband. Kom maar laat je overspoelen, door alweer een avontuur. Oh, Vinks Club, Vinks, de magische Vinks. Vlieg met ons door de lucht. De kracht van het licht is bij ons. Volg de magische Vinks.
Jesus Christ. Yes, if you're wondering, that is the intro scene, the title song from the Dutch dub of Vinks Club. At least my horrible, horrible rendition of it. I love that intro title song, but also, my god, I'm a horrible singer. Nee, not again. Oh shit, no. Imps are pretty cute, aren't they? Maybe not as cute as goblins, but well, they are still pretty cute. Let's say they are ogre tier. We should make a cuteness tier list. Yes! S tier, goblins. A tier, ogres, sprites, undead, quiggles, bats, ghosts. B tier, slimes, dragons, canines, ungulates, fish. C tier, men, women, plantoids, wasps. D tier, Croco girls. Upvoted, liked, subscribed. Yeah, that is your reaction to this video. Remember to comment and like and subscribe, or else.
Or else... something. Me. Oh my god, this quest. Alright. The dungeon! Ooh. I love bones. I just really fucking love bones. One day I'll love your bones. Fucking bones. I'm stuck guarding the dingy dinky dungeons. And I think that skeleton wants to kill me and harvest my bones. Do goblins have bones? I don't know. Oh god, there's people outside. I hope they don't hear me. I really hope they don't hear me. God, I hope they don't hear me. Yes, he's going inside.
Yes, yes, he's going inside. Yes, good.
Ah, I love the smell of disgusting dung deluged dungeons. What do you think of my scent? It scents scents within senses. You smell delicious. I hate you. Go away.
So mean. So this is the power of the dungeon goblin guard.
Now we come to this room, which is quite a room.
Delicious! Divine! Delectable!
I'm glad I finally found a bathroom. Try some? Delicious. Imagine writing a conversation like this. Imagine indeed. Got seconds? Soon. Not yet. Do you have to watch? Yes. So you have found me, the master of faces.
I am a goblin.
I am a dog. I am a zombie.
I am a skeleton.
I am a shadow.
I am a phlegmatic.
I am a choleric.
I am a sanguine.
I am a melancholic. I am a faceless. Wait, are you a master of faces or feces? Ah, you're right, I got them mixed up again. My bad. I'm a master of feces. I look forward to a minute from now when I am no longer in this specific area of this specific room. Oh, wily file. Like this isn't your favorite room. I find the goings on in this room repulsive, repugnant, and disgusting. The fact that someone wasted their time in creating this makes me lose all hope in humanity. Please do carry on. You know, this isn't so bad, really. Would be better, but well, it could be worse. I'm giving it a 3.5 out of 5 stars.
3.5 out of 5?!
My god, what was I thinking? 4 out of 5 stars. That's the spirit. Wouldn't it be strange if you didn't say anything? If it was just me talking at you and not with you. And you would expect one for you to say something, but you just don't. You just don't say anything. It would be really weird. Yeah, weird. Seriously weird. I really like that conversation in particular, because it's like the only time you talk to an NPC, but the NPC doesn't even say anything. You're just talking at the NPC.
Sally!
Sally. I'm once again looking outside to see whether there's anyone outside, and there's nobody outside. Okay, good. Am I? What if you're my boss? Are you going to toss me in jail? No, that would be weird. I am studying your evil dungeon, however. You seem to have imprisoned some powerful paladins?
Yes! Specifically I! And me too?
Yes, they could probably easily kill me, so... why are all the prisons unlocked?
Wait, they are? Oh, damn it!
We believe in free-range livestock. It's the humane way to do business. I'll wipe that down.
Milking time? Boo!
What exactly are they doing here anyway? Where are we?
I don't know!
They are paladins. Clearly they're here to save a princess.
Wait, are you a princess?
No.
Are you a prince?
I'm not a boy! I think girls can be princes too. Stop being so narrow-minded.
Rude? Very rude.
I'm sorry for being rude. But also, I'm just an intern and not royalty. Oh well. clearly I will need to make you a princess. So vote goes to have a princess to save. I'm such a genius, I wish I thought of it. You did think of it. Don't be so modest.
By the powers vested in me by me when I was wearing a cool vest, I declare you Princess Sally.
Can I be a princess? Me too. Yes.
By the power vested in me when I was wearing a cool vest, I declare you princesses.
I want a name. Princess name?
Your princess names are Princess Princess and Princess Pool.
Princess Pool is an awful name. Yeah, that name sucks hard. You can both be Princess Princess. I hope Luminuxissimus saves us. Who is that? Our brother? Yes.
Wow, I feel like we learned a lot about nothing right now.
That's this quest in a nutshell. That's life for you. Well, now that I'm a princess, I'll quit as an intern. I quit too. Are we interns? Of course not. You're princesses. Get back to scrubbing the floors like a princess does. What about milking? Moo! Everybody knows princesses are for milking.
Yes. Give me your ogre produce.
Yogurt cheese.
Incredible. So efficient. You don't need me to milk you, you can milk each other, or milk yourselves. What are we milking? Yeah, good question. Milk, of course, what else?
Seriously, why do the royal needs a glass of milk?
I'll have some milk. Who do you think you are? You say Fudo? Can I have some too?
No, the milk is mine. Also, this conversation ends here. Because like, wow, this is already like super long, jeez. It's like it should end, but it just keeps going anyway. Over and over and over. Also, it's becoming hard to keep track of the number of punctuation signs.
What is punctuation? I hate punctuation.
Ugh, paladins. I prefer the pink and gold one. Wonder where he is now. Maybe he can hook me up with a goblin too.
Why did my accent suddenly become like that? Who are you? I'm Wily Vile. I'm the man who's going to destroy the world. Why? I've seen better worlds. Such as? Yeah, my god, writing for this character was horrible because it's so difficult to write for someone who only asks questions. Is this funny? No, it's not. Questioning reply? Okay, yeah, that is funny. I want another bed.
Why?
So we can sleep more. Moo! Ah, fine.
Moo!
Judge. Let's see, what else?
The Eithrim?
Yes, I admit it. I am, as my overworld sprite would suggest, extremely bald.
Eta Lupopmuskit.
Yes, I admit it. I am, as my overworld sprite would suggest, extremely not bald. Yeah, like, the Mondesi overworld sprites are really buggy. Oh dear. Oh my dear, no. No, 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 no! My dearest dear! You're nowhere near pink enough for this room. Says who? Why, I, of course. Pinkadelia Prudence. Perfect pink appreciator. Princess apparent for using pink pigments. Now get the hell out of my sight. Nevermore tarnish my sight if you're horrid like pink. Do you wish for death? Well, you'll need something. Binko's essence of pink. Oh my dear, what could you be looking at? Pinko. Pinko power! Pass on through. Did you just walk through me? Noise. Oh my dearest dear. I cannot. Pinko. Really done it. I will carry on his legacy, and my face will be positively pink! My dearest dear, your essence is without, not within. Death will find you. Ominous. I'm sick of walking up and down these stairs! I get excited watching guard number 46 running up and down the stairs!
Yes! The art gallery. Oh, hello! I'm Fizzle Popstar, so happy to meet you! I'm painting my cute doggy wookie! I dropped my paintbrush! Yeah, I'm so clumsy! Yeah? Yeah. Yeah. I swallow paint! I push my teeth with a paintbrush! Paint me like one of your city goblins! These tights are painted on! Yes! Paintbrushes are tingly!
Please, I need to concentrate. How do you paint with your eyes closed? Oh, please, I do not paint what I see. I merely paint what I perceive. The very essence of goblinhood. I think you might be painting the goblin instead of the canvas. Nonsense. Would you believe some people think I'm creepy because I only use cream-colored faces? There's no way anyone who talks like that could ever be creepy. Of course not. Yes. This leafage would fit perfectly over there. But please excuse me, I'm drawing a portrait of leafage in a forest. But where's the joke? Why would there be a joke? Please, sir, I'm trying to paint.
Hey, that's another painting, Finny. This will go nicely in my collection of objets d'art. Dear God, what the hell is that accent? Ah, mon cheval, un bisou pour toi. Stand back. Zut, excusez-moi. I am très excité. The pleasure of my very own gallery d'art going so very well. To think my own gallery in tears, Blissville.
Yeah, so we did fun fact.
Oui!
I eagerly await the grand opening. I look forward to it when it's done.
In 100 years! Je suis Madame la Craque.
Yeah. Will inspiration ever strike?
Hello, Karim! I love your paintings!
Sir, my name is Quive, not Karim.
Attagirl! Keep at it, my dear Karim. You'll be the top artist soon. Does truly nobody know how to pronounce my name? Karim, 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 Karim.
Quive. Tobias, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. But also, thank you for watching this. I plainly love to mainly painlessly plainly paint plain plants in the plain plains. That's a great tongue twister, I love that. Oh god, it's this guy. You have to take a sip.
Oh, so you are trying to steal my naughty thunder with your silly laugh, are you? How very naughty! I like it!
So, Lord Naughtiness, what naughtiness are you up to today?
What a naughty question! I'll be extra naughty and not answer it! That was a lie! A naughty lie! I have, through naughtiness and guile, sabotaged the gallery. Indeed, what used to be a basic at back gallery is now a naughty gallery.
Oh, hide minors.
Indeed, hide your children, my foolish children. This gallery contains only the most naughty of artworks. So behold, the many paintings of naughtiness. Number one. A picture of a goblin and a paladin holding hands. How naughty! A picture of a creepy smiling man shaving a pink deck.
How naughty!
A picture of a skeleton baring its pelvis. How naughty! A picture of a goblin baring its pelvis. How naughty! A picture of you bearing a creepy smile with two scarlet eyes. How naughty!
picture of Lord Naughtiness! How handsome! And super duper ultra mega naughty!
This voice is really difficult.
A picture of the number zero! How naughty!
Get it?
This picture is blank! Someone stole it! How naughty! This picture contains a picture of this picture, which contains a picture of this picture! How naughty! I'm not even going to describe this picture! Use your imagination for once!
How naughty!
A picture of goblins in a forest, panicking while assaulted by various fae! How naughty!
How inspiring!
And so very naughty! Yes! That's it! Let the naughtiness flow through you! Cut me down with all your naughtiness! And your path to the naughty side is complete!
Oh, this voice is really... Oh my god, this voice is horrible.
Now that you have become sufficiently naughty, you are worthy of this naughty ocean.
This is way too difficult.
You can now examine child. How naughty!
Yeah, the naughty.
Nani!
Oh, you. Yes, we have to go to the throne room. God, that voice. Jesus Christ. Ugh. So we have now the power to examine chairs. Worth it. Posing me buttocks. A farting noise. So we have opened this room. A secret room! You found the secret room, well done! This secret room acts as a sort of a shortcut to the throne room. Who knows, maybe there's something there you can examine. Please do enjoy the rest of the quest. Who knows, perhaps you'll meet again? Or perhaps it will be us meeting each other. Fine, just this once. Just once.
I'm a secret goblin! This is my secret cave! I'm so lonely.
Boo!
Heek!
Huh? Music to my ears. It is very cute. So yeah, that was a shortcut. We're almost at the end of the quest. Amazing! Oh, I've been having so much fun with this. And the fun is only going to get more fun. Time for the fun ending! This is the worst throne ever, if only I had a cushion. Ah, but that's right, Lord Naughtiness gave us one. But what about our evening milk? Oh right, we can drink Sally's cheese. Attaboy! I'm a girl! Yeah, I quit! But... we need some reading material, something that is more than this reality. We can read Lesenfort's report. Wait, no, that's actually really boring and tedious. We need something spicy, we need... Hoi, goblin studs! Typo!
Sweet holy mother, yes!
Kia years. What goblin studs. But... it would be much easier to read if we had two eyes. But luckily, our dearest friend and closest compatriot, Black Death, gave us our second eye. Wonder where she got it from?
Ain't it wrong out of your death eye socket, Death? Curve wiping sewer brain!
Let's just plop it right in. I never thought I'd be back here again. Back home. Oh, my comfy old eye socket. Oh, those guys down there, they really messed up. I should give them what they deserve. I will give them their evil quest. Well, no. First things first.
What?
Hello there! Did you have fun? Did this body suit you well? It is such a good body after all.
Yes! This body is the best!
And might I say, so is yours. Meow. Pathetic. Scolded by myself, oh my! We are not one in the same. Disappear from my sight, filth. So, things are happening! Curious and curiouser. So we can lower his stats. And this combat is actually really easy. Look at that, pathetic. You're not doing anything to me. Oh, he's immune to physical damage, it seems. What should we do? What should we do? Well, that should do it.
What?
Perish. Now then, it's time. Call together the guard. Salutations, my dear guard goblins.
Hi, boss, you look different. Did you get a new haircut?
No, I clearly did not. I did get a new eyeball, though. Courtesy of my dear henchwoman, Black Death. What did she...
That two-timing harpy! I am whispering because of my yelling voice too! Yoo-hoo!
Black Death, please do tell me why you ganked my eyeball out.
Yeah, blubberin'.
It hurt. A lot. So now I'm going to hurt you. Have you gone deaf, mate? Oil bleeding? You will be bleeding, certainly. And now finally Black Death lives up to her name. Foolish slash she was. Ganking out my eye, now that's a stupid mistake, but then to give it back? That's just plain stupid. I won't endure any more foolishness. Lord Naughtiness, die.
You?
Now then, my dear wife,
yes?
Your services won't be needed anymore. Consider this our divorce. Well, maybe more of a divorce. And finally, Dr. Lesonfort. I knew this day would come. Congratulations on your promotion. Of all the underlings I spoke with today, you're one of the few to deserve this honor. My lord, say no more. This castle is under new management. Go work on your breach project. I have one or two propositions to make to the Alumna. The sooner we get there, the better. Don't go getting cold feet. Tell the R&D Mondizi to drop their pet projects. If they refuse, dispose of them. Of course, my lord, I will go do as instructed. As for all your guards, your drivel irritates me. Never speak to me again unless instructed.
Was that an instruction?
No. Any questions? Good. Meeting dismissed. Return to your posts. Oh, and someone please clean up the mess I made. Everything is operational, my lord. You need only examine the tree now. And you are sure of this? All test results came back positive, my lord. Good. Wonderful. Are you getting second thoughts, my lord? Anxiety must be getting to me. It's not every day you get to meet your maker. I shall visit them now. The Alumna. You were the only useful subject I ever had. So my old self was good for one thing at least. Yes, I suppose it was a rare occasion of competence. Enough reminiscence. Why hello! My name is Wily Vile. I would like very much to visit the Alumna now. So please, do bring me to the end. Your wish, our command. Peer into the void, beyond good, beyond evil, beyond chaos, beyond order, beyond unisys, breach through the nexus. Welcome, Lord Wile E. Vile. At long last, after 7 years,
I am finally where I belong. You can come out now. I know you're here. I can sense you. There's no need to be shy.
Okay then! Hi! I'm God! You've been looking for me, huh?
Okay. Really, I mean it. You can appear now.
I'm here! I'm God! I made all this stuff! I made the Barbari, I made the battles, I made the Nexus! And finally I made the goblins in my own image!
And really, I do mean it. You can appear now.
Wow, I am here! Listen to me, please! I was starting to get bored of my creations, as I always do. And when I get bored, I destroy! Then I can make something new, something better!
No, you cannot be serious.
I like you, Vile. You're fun. You make funny faces and smile a lot, but you're also really evil. That's so weird and strange. You don't even scowl or yell or anything. It's not like what I used to make, so I don't want to destroy you.
Did Lazon Fort mess up? Where am I?
No, he didn't fail. He brought you to the creator, which is me. Why don't you believe me? Maybe I made the goblins too strongly in my own image. But I want your input when I make my next world. I can make the good guys and you can make the bad guys. And maybe we could hang out? Maybe go on a date with me? Us?
I'm starting to lose my patience.
This is nothing like how it goes when I make it. Doesn't the villain always hook up with the hero? That's why I need to destroy the world. I need fresh ideas. And that's why I need you.
Shut up.
Huh?
You're not God.
Yes I am, it's in my name. I'm level 20 and all my stats are 99. How can I not be God?
Because you're not the Olma, you silly. I'm done with the test now, you guys.
There is no test. Maybe I should destroy you too. I don't even want to go on a date with you anymore. You were much cuter when you had an eye patch anyway. I'm leaving. Good boy, bad boy. Blech.
Well then, it's finally time. Time to meet my makers and give them a piece of my mind. Faithful one, return to the Aster. Meet your maker, finally. So much waiting, but it's finally here. It ends now. Are you ready? I'm ready. Destruction. Creation. Sorrow. Courage, fear, bliss, all combine into one. Lord Vile E. Vile, welcome to reality.
Hello. It's me. It's Mania. This is the ending I made for this quest. Oh god. You didn't want to meet your maker, so hey, why not? Might be interesting, right? Yeah. Yeah. It would be hard to top this ending. What is it you're doing?
Sitting here at my PC, having a sip of my bottle of water.
Writing this. Speaking of, I'm also going to have a sip. Yeah. Lord Wily Vile, he didn't even exist the day before I had this idea for an ending. Let alone 7 years ago, again, a quest made over the course of 7 years. But I've been waiting for so long. Yeah, I've been waiting for 7 years to finish this, putting it off, out of sight, out of mind. Didn't even know how to end this really, so why not make something crazy? Maybe it doesn't need to make sense, well, maybe it doesn't. I have no idea what you're blabbering about, or do you? I completely understand what you're blabbering about. Yeah, it's really that easy, you know, when you're making a quest. If you want something to be a certain way, you can just make it. An NPC suddenly changes their mind, yeah, they just do it. You write the quest, you decide. So what happens to me then? Nothing. It's over. There's no big climax, I mean. The big climax was the scene with like... Lord Wily Vile appearing. This is just like a post-climax nonsense epilogue. Well, it should end like this.
incredibly self-indulgent. It is very self-indulgent, Mania from the past. It is very... Calling myself out, are we? I am getting thirsty. How dare you call me out, Mania from the past? God, you asshole! Can you believe this guy? Me from the past, can you believe this guy? That's a joke, yes. Thank you, Mania, for pointing out to myself that barely anyone watches this crap. I am very happy you made it this far, yes. Yeah, Two-Eyed Wily File was very fun to write for. Like, Sarrow? God, Sarrow was a mess. If I had written Sarrow like Wily File, I might have actually, like, finished that quest. Yeah, yelling and wacky faces. Lord Wily File doesn't do that, he's very subtle. This is very sad. Can you believe this? Can you believe this absolute idiot? There won't be any more quests. Goes on to make more quests anyway. Fucking liar. No more Sorrelot. Well, that's true. No more Denarius? Bullshit! How about Destiny of Luminixissime? You bitch! No more quests? Van Gopfink, Art Quest. Van Gopfink, Mania stupid and wrong. It would be nice. Yeah, it would be nice.
It would be very nice. Oh.
Fine. It's the final quest. No, it's not. You liar. Oh, Tobias. I won't blame you if you don't do anything with a Laura Finn creation. But no more quests. Oh, but I will finish off the quest requests, right? Because people really want those. I don't think people really care about them, but I care about them. Yes, and we're doing the yelling again. Some things never change. I'm patting myself on the back. It hurts. Well. Yes. Actually. There. Goblin, lovely. How did we not actually hit the boss yet? This is Mania logging off. Stoppen! You're too old for my spell to work. That's a vintage classic Mania. Now I'm going to destroy the world! Yay! My next world is going to have nothing but gay male goblins! Oh man, gay male goblins. I love gay male goblins. I really love them. I like, yeah, gay male goblins, love those. You can have my quest files if you ask for them, like, just ask me, but don't ask for any more quests. Gay goblin time!
Yes!
So, happy ending, right? Goblin destroys the world, everybody dies, but the goblins survive, right? Goblin Knight's there, Goblin is still alive, That one goblin that got killed by Wily File, he's alive. And all the goblins are adorable, and there's thousands of them, of different types. They're all adorable, they're all gay. They're having like big gay orgies, but they're also like somehow still having children. Don't ask me how it works. Goblin works in mysterious ways. Happy gay goblins forever and ever. The end. Man. Evil quest. I must admit, this was a lot of fun. I enjoyed this much more than expected. This took like an hour and 40 minutes. But man, I got really into this, especially the voice acting. My voice doesn't even hurt that much. So yeah, I'm really happy with this quest actually. I think it's really good. Like, not all the jokes are always entirely funny, but like a lot of them are just funny to me. I really enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed it too. I'm actually really looking forward to doing Destiny of Luminixissime next. I think that one is actually my best quest so far. So yeah, good stuff. I really do feel proud of my 2020 quests.
which makes me feel a bit sad when, well, there isn't much of an audience for them, right? There's like two or three people who actually play them, and that's it. But, well, I also play them and I enjoy them. And I have damn good taste, so there's that. So, yeah. Next time, next Knee of Numenixissime, we'll see when that happens. It's going to be a longer quest. It's going to be a very long video. As for this video, well, the only thing I can say now is stoppen.